Okay, thank you very much. So this work has been done in collaboration with Andrew Dabalen and Vasco Molini from the World Bank and Francesco Schettino from Italy, from the Second University of Naples. So the focus of this work is on Nigeria, and it basically builds upon a recent narrative according to which the poverty-reducing benefits from stable and sustained growth, which has been experienced by the country over the last decade, has been offset partly by an increase of inequality. For example, according to a recent report from the World Bank, the rise of inequality, which has been experienced by Nigeria over the last decade, in particular between 2004 and 2010, has wiped out almost a half of the poverty drop, which could have been realized if there was no increase in inequality, only by income growth, we could say. Building upon this narrative, what we do in the present work is moving a step forward. Our main working hypothesis is that Nigeria in recent years is also going through a process of economic polarization. Basically, we could have two different views of polarization in the literature. The first one, which has been initiated by the works of Foster and Wolfson, is mainly concerned with the disappearance of a middle class, which we have when the distribution of a population according to a particular economic variable is more concentrated in the tails rather than in the middle of the distribution. The second view of polarization, which is a more general view, regards polarization as clustering of groups of populations around the local poles of the distribution, let's say local modes or means of the distribution, independently on where they are located along the income or consumption scale. But notwithstanding these differences, we could say that basically, both the views of polarization share the common idea that the more polarized the society is, the more social conflict is likely to arise. We think that Nigeria represents actually an interesting case for undertaking a polarization analysis, since, as told before, during the last decade, GDP growth was substantially in the country, but still clear signs, evidence of consolidation of a national middle class are limited. In addition, as you probably know, Nigeria is actually affected by a growing number of sub-regional conflicts. Studies on polarization in Nigeria are very few, and the main problem we found was that there is a limited availability of data series which are fully comparable over time. So the main problem which hindered the scope of previous work was having at disposal data which are comparable over time. Data cannot comparable over time if, for example, from one point in time to the other one, there has been changes in data collection methodology. So we first faced this problem. The first problem was that of producing comparable data sets over time before facing the problem of analyzing polarization in Nigeria. What about the data in Nigeria? There are several household surveys on consumption expenditure in most African economies. The main welfare variable which is used for this kind of analysis is consumption, and we also refer to consumption. There is, for example, the National Living Standard Survey and the follow-up, which is a harmonized National Living Standard Survey, which are the most frequently used by, for example, the National Bureau of statistics to explore, to monitor progress in poverty reduction over the resilience. But actually the National Bureau of Statistics in Nigeria also conduct another important consumption household survey, which is called the General Household Survey, which is conducted in collaboration with the World Bank. What we do here for constructing the data, which should be, we hope, comparable over time, is to take the most updated and reliable data on household consumption expenditure in Nigeria, that is the GHS data, the General Household Survey consumption data, and use them to reconstruct backward consumption expenditures in time. This approach is called the survey-to-survey technique, which is basically an exercise of this kind. We estimate a model of local per capita consumption expenditure using the most updated and reliable data, and we use the estimated coefficients on this data to reconstruct the consumption expenditure backward in time with reference to the National Living Standard Survey, which is the oldest one we have at our disposal. This because essentially the two household surveys are not comparable between them, because there has been a revision of the data collection methodology in the meanwhile. And also they are not comparable because we did some preliminary checks, some experiments. For example, we calculated some preliminary figures on inequality and poverty levels, and the figures differ substantially. So we were forced, we can say, to use this kind of methodology to reconstruct to at least two distributions in the most at different points in time, which are the most distant between them when possible. In this case, we are able to cover about a decade. Why this kind of exercise? Because these are diagnostic plots, but I will prefer to say you about the methodology we use for export polarization. Why this kind of exercise to reconstruct comparable data series on consumption expenditures in time over a relatively long time? Well, sincerely and basically because if there are no sudden shocks, phenomena like inequality, poverty, polarization change very slowly in time. So significant changes can be detected only over a relatively long period of time. So we need, before data series which cover at least a decade, and we succeeded in reconstructing at least data series distribution which cover a decade. And secondly, because the methodology we use to explore polarization, and this is a kind of methodology is quite different from the other methodology which has been used by previous work on polarization in Nigeria, like for example simply computing, let's say, standard measures of polarization and comparing them between time, is a non-parametric methodology, the one we use, and is called the relative distribution. It is based essentially on the comparison of two distributions in time, and hopefully the distribution which are very distant in time, like for example in our case, because we have a distribution for the most recent data in 2013, and simulated one, we can say, for 2003. So we were able to cover with our data at least a decade. And this kind of methodology we use is based, as I said, as on a comparison of two distribution. Let's say, for example, the one at time t minus 1 in 2003 in our case, and the one at time t at 2013 in our case. It's simply the relative distribution, it is simply the ratio between the two densities, okay? And in particular, there are some advantages which are linked to this kind of a methodology, in particular the possibility to explore the sources of changes you can see when proceed to compare distribution. For example, this distribution enable us to perform a decomposition into location and shape changes. We can see only composition due to some kind of median or mean shift, or changes due only redistribution, and so a change in distributions compared over time only due to shape changes, modification in the shape. And furthermore, and finally, about the methodology, distribution, this kind of methodology also give us the possibility of quantifying what we can say at the graphical level, because it brings a set of indices which are called the relative polarization indices, and in particular the first one, the median relative polarization index, gives you the possibility to see if there is movement from the middle of the distribution toward the tails, and moreover it is decomposable into other two indices, the lower relative polarization index and the upper one, which gives us also the direction other than the magnitude of the change. For example, we can say in this case if there is more polarization in the lower tail, which is called downgrading of distribution, or more polarization in the upper tail. But let's see the results. This table we have some preliminary summary statistics which concerns the data. The second column, this one, is the one referring to the most recent data set, the one coming from the generalized from the general household survey, and refer to the years 2012 and 2013, simply because it's made in the second half of the first year and in the first half of the second year. The statistics shown in the first column on the table instead refer to the simulated distribution, the one obtained by means of the survey-to-survey technique, and they refer to the data, the summary statistics shown there, which come from the National Longitudinal Living Survey. This is the oldest data we have at our disposal and the one we have simulated. Apart from the changes which are shown by the increase in the mean and median expenditure, and also the changes in dispersion of the distribution, the most notable features are that there is a deterioration, we can say, between the two points in times of the consumption share of bottom percentiles of the distribution, and an increase of the consumption share of the top percentiles of the distribution. We have also calculated an inequality measures, as like for example the Gini and Tile indexes, and both show an increase of inequality. And obviously we have also calculated polarization measures, standard polarization measures, like for example the Foster-Wolfson and the one given by Duclos, Esteban and Ray, and both even though more slightly compared to the inequality phenomenon, show an increase of polarization in this case. But let's see how it works in this case on the ground, the relative distribution methodology. In this figure, you have in the upper left corner simply the non-parametric estimatedly kernel densities of the two distributions which are at the beginning of our time period in 2003 and the end of the our period 2013. You can see this lines give you the median of the distribution, you can see that there is an increase, a location shift from one period of time to the other, like we saw in the summary statistics in the preceding tables, and there is also an alteration, a change in the shape of the distribution when we move from 2003 to in 2013. The subsequent graph, which is called the relative distribution, is simply the ratio at any decile, if you want, but also if you like, at any percentile of the distribution of the 2003, which is the reference one, which we compare the most recent distribution, and you have this kind of pattern. What you see, there is an increase in the share of household in the deciles of the reference distribution, the 2003 distribution, above the median of the reference distribution, which is the 2003-1, and a decreasing share of household below the median number, the same. So there is a general change, we can say, okay, in the distribution. But what is the main source of this change? Like we see, but it's also visible here in the table, there is an increase of the median, okay? So we have probably a location shift. And the location shift is shown here. This is the location effect which operated in this kind of general change, overall change that we can observe. And the location effect is quite significant, okay? But as most of it's of the shape, okay, but this is not the shape in terms of redistribution, okay, but the shape of this graph, of this curve, is quite similar to this one, but it's not really the same. There are other changes which probably are due to the fact that other than increase in location, location shift of the distribution, there are also changes in shape redistribution, okay, net of this median effect or mean effect, or net of this location shift. And these changes are given in the last plot, okay? Here you have, as you can see, a U-shaped pattern. And this kind of U-shaped pattern is simply polarization, because you have an increase of the share of a household in the lower decile of the distribution, an increase of the share of households in the upper decile of the distribution, and a decrease of the share of household in the middle of the distribution. This is the changes that are only due to changes in the shape of the distribution, that is, in redistribution, net of the location effect. Both the effect have operated to produce this kind of overall changes. When we move to quantify our polarization phenomenon, because as I told before, there are also the possibility to use polarization indices, we can say that all the indices are positive, and also they are significantly positive. This first value tells us that there is a kind of process of polarization in the consumption distribution of Nigerian households, and this polarization is both a polarization in the lower tail of the distribution and in the upper one. This kind of polarization that we can say at the national level, it's obviously because Nigeria is highly heterogeneous, is a big economy, is a populous country, it's not entirely homogeneous within the country, but for example it varies from zone to zone. There is a south of the country which is more polarized of the north one. I stop here and I skip also the conclusions because the problem is a kind of summary of the results. I just do the last remark, which is the fact that this kind of analysis will prepare the ground for further research on the link which exists and is which is supposed to exist in the literature between the fact that more polarized society are more conflict prone, and in Nigeria basically we have probably both the features of this kind of further research. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So we have a few minutes, and I'd like to then collect a few questions from the audience and then give our presenters a few minutes to respond. So let's start here in the front of the room. We have microphones that will be coming to you because we're recording.